Hi, thank you for joining us here at Hospitality and Entertainment. My name is Russ Fritz. I'm a senior systems designer here, and today I'd like to talk to you about RF taps, splitters, and attenuators. First thing we'll get into is what are the use of taps, splitters, and attenuators. They take an RF signal, such as from a cable system, a satellite system, or an antenna system, and distribute it out to individual TVs or amplifiers or zones. Most of the time it's used in a distribution that goes directly to the TVs. Splitters are the first thing we're going to talk about. A splitter is the most common item that you're used to seeing. You've seen this all around. It takes one TV signal input, and it could split it in various ways. It could be a 4 output one like you see. It could be an 8 output one like that, and it could even go as large as a 16 output such unit. These are nice, but are very used in a very specific manner. These take an input of one power and distribute it out evenly to the rest of the ports, which basically means if you take 30 dBs going in and you go to each of these outputs, this splitter tells you that it's minus 7 dBs. So if you were going in with 30 dBs, this would have 23 dBs, 23 dBs, 23 dBs, 23 dBs. Everything is equal as far as output. What goes in is equally divided between the whole splitter system. A tap is a little bit different. A tap, which you can see is a little bit different design. I'm going to hold it a little bit different for you. What goes on here is the signal comes in one port, goes out the other port, and this is made to go directly to the TV. But this has a controlled output. This is going to control all the signal and not waste signal. A splitter wastes signal many, many times. I'm going to go to a chart, and I'm going to show you a little bit of graphics, going to try to explain to you how you should use a tap. If you use a splitter in your TV system, which a lot of locations, a lot of facilities are doing, a lot of buildings are doing, the problem with that is you have different lengths of cable going to different TVs. You could have a TV that's 20 feet away from the amplifier, which only needs maybe about, 10 dBs of amplification. Then you've got a wire that's going 190 feet away to the last TV. Well, that's getting the same power as the first TV. There's no way that's going to equal out. Somewhere TVs are going to have signal problems. You can't take a splitter and equally divide it out to go 10 feet, 50 feet, 100 feet, 200 feet, 300 feet. You do not use a splitter for that use. And uses where you're going to continue and do long runs and keep hooking up equipment, you're going to use a tap. Now I'm going to show you, go to a graph and show you how a tap works. Let me adjust my picture quality here a little bit. I'm going to take you to this chart. Let me adjust this a little better, get a little more control on my product. Here is a typical use of the DB. This is a 4 TV system that I'm going to show you. First of all, if you look, you're going to see where the input of the splitter. This is a tap. It has the input, it has the output, and it has the output to the TV. We start our system with 30 dBs going into the first splitter. 30 dBs going into the first splitter. We want to get a 6 dB signal level to the TV. Each of these taps has a value printed on them. In this case, we would use a 24 dB tap. We take that 24, we minus it from the input power of 30, and guess what we end up with? Our 6 dBs. That's how we figure out how we're going to get the 6 dBs to each TV. Every time the signal changes in power, we're going to add in a different tab with a different value to it. Value meaning the output power. This could come in either 16, 24, 9, 3, it comes in all different kind of values for you to work with. So now, these units do lose power. You see it says 1 dB loss up there. That's because this tap is making me lose 1 dB of power. I'm going into it with 30 dBs. I'm losing my 1 dB of loss because of the tap itself. And then I'm coming out with 29 dBs, and at the same time, I'm feeding the TV 6 dBs. That's my first TV. Now, say my second TV is 100 feet away, 100 feet of RG6 cable, I'm going to lose 6 dBs of power on that 100-foot cable length. That's what I'm going to lose power-wise. So going into my second tap for my second TV, with my 29 dBs coming out, my 6 dBs of loss, I am now hitting the second tap with 23 dBs. Because it's a 16 dB, how did I get to that 16 dBs? Again, I take 23, I want to achieve 6. What number is going to get me that 6 dBs away from that 23 dB input? I would use a 16 dB tap. I lose 2 dBs because that's what the manufacturer is telling me I lose in a 16 dB tap. I go from 23 in to 21 out, and my TV gets my 6 dBs, and I have a 2 dB loss. Again, 23 in, 21 out, 2 dB loss because of the mechanics of the tap, and my TV sees 6 dBs. Now, my third TV, I'm going to travel another 100 feet. Follow my little wire, my little diagram. Well, how professional this is, huh? Now, here is my third TV. Since I lost 100 feet coming out of the 21, up here is the 21 dB output of the second tap, I lose my 100, I lose my 6 dBs on my 100 feet of cable, and my third splitter is now 15 dBs going in. Manufacturer tells me I'm going to lose 3 dBs on my mechanics of my tap. Gives me a 12 dB output. 15 in, 12 out. I want to get my 6 dB to my TV. So what do I need to get to that 15 with that 15? Is a 9 dB tap. 9 minus 15 gives me my 6 dBs. Now, my last TV in line is only 50 feet away. So now I'm only going to lose 3 dBs of signal on that 50 foot of cable. But I get to my last splitter, and again, value is changing here all the time, every splitter. And you can see how the signal is changing each time we use this a tap. Where if we were using a splitter, this would not be happening. A splitter would just be jamming out the power in an incorrect way. My 50 feet, I lose 3 dBs. I hit my tap with 9 dBs in. I lose 3 dBs of loss because the manufacturer says that on this mechanicals part. My last output, or to go any further, I'm at 6 dBs out. I take my 6, I want my 6 at the TV, so I put a 3 dB tap in there. 9 in, 6 out, 3 loss, 3 dB, 6 to the TV. That would be the end of my system, because after this, if you look at it, 6 dBs, what can I do with that? There's nothing I can do. I mean, if I put another one of these in line, I'm minus 0 dBs already, so I'm done at this point. So I have two options. I either stop hooking up TVs, or I add a second amp. And again, I'd be going into this amp. If I had a 30 dB amp, my 6 dBs in, 36 dBs out, and then I would start the process all over. Let me explain what's happening in your facility and why you probably don't have the signal quality that you have. As I guarantee that you might be using taps, but the problem is a lot of people want to add in one amplifier and try to run 16 or 18 patient rooms or 16 lodging rooms. You just can't do that. You need to have multiple amplifiers, because as you go through your system, even with taps, you're going to eventually run out of power. Many times when we go on service calls to facilities, when they call us in and say, we just have a terrible signal. The issue with that signal is because the first TV is doing great, second TV is doing great, even the 10th TV is doing great. But when you get to the 15th and 20th, you're not seeing any power. I put a meter onto it, and I can't even get the meter to light up because there's absolutely no power. That is why you're getting a bad signal at these TVs. Many, many times, the use of a second, maybe even a third amplifier in line is needed. You can kick the power. You can put a 50 or 60. You can start out with 50 and 60 dBs. Again, but I stress to you, when you go so many feet and so many taps, you eventually eat that power up. We ate 30 dBs of power up in 4 TVs. So even if you had 50 dBs and it was only, instead of 100 feet, between rooms, it was only 5 feet, you're still only going to get maybe another 6 or 8 TVs out of the scenario. And think about it. If you have, if 30 dBs eats up 10 TVs, that's kind of fast. I mean, it takes up kind of a lot of power. So even when you're using taps, you're going to have the issue of running out of power in your facility. And I guarantee, meter the first TV in line and meter the last TV in line. One will show you good power. The last one, your meter probably won't even be able to pick up. Attenuators. What are attenuators? Attenuators are little. They look just like an RF coax connector, except they're an attenuator with a value on it. Values could be 3, 6, 9, 12, 14, 16, 20, 24. And what does that mean to you? If you already have amplifiers installed in your facility and you don't have 6 dBs going to each TV, or you don't have enough power, too much power feeding into the amplifiers, these you put in line and it'll take down that power of according to the value that you put in. If you have a TV that's getting right now 20 dBs of power, you're going to burn out that TV in time. Have you ever noticed in your facility, you say, man, I've only had these TVs 2 years and they're all breaking down on me. The reason they're breaking down is 10 to 1, you have too much power going in to the TV. And yes, that affects the whole TV because it's making that tuner, overloading that tuner with power. So eventually that tuner is going to give out on you. You want that TV to see between 0 and 6 dBs. I like 6 dBs. So if you had 20 dBs going into the TV, what size attenuator would you need to get to that 6 dBs? Of course, you would need a 14 dB attenuator. Attenuators can be combined. You could put a 6, and a 3 dB and get close to that, still that 16 dB. You could mix and match. It's if you go into your facility and you don't see the use of attenuators in certain places, or you don't even see an attenuator used anywhere, no one balanced your system. To balance a system, you need the use of taps, you need the use of attenuators, and a few splitters. Splitters are not recommended really in any situation. I could only think of just using taps all the time because taps just always make the power and correctly distributed to all the areas. Another thing to remember is watching how much you attenuate, because if you attenuate too much, you could also cause the opposite problem of not having enough power. So in RF systems, a percentage of 1 dB can make the difference of a clean picture and a bad picture. It's unbelievable where you'll be tuning in a system and you'll be fine-tuning an amplifier, and sure enough, you will get it to where you are at 19 dBs and the signal doesn't look good enough. You go to 20, 22, it looks terrible. You go to 20 and it's perfect. 1 dB can cause such a difference in your signal you would not believe. So that's the basics of splitters, taps, and attenuators. Again, we can help you with all these problems that you have. We offer service 24/7. We come into your facility and we will fix it in the middle of the night. There's no extra charge for that. It's just our industry demands working all different shifts, and that's how we do it. So again, thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you have further questions, please feel free to give us a call. One thing we want to tell you too is there's another section of video training that we have on our website for RF distribution. You should watch that. That goes along with what I just told you. And also there's another video talking about coax cable and the connectors that are used on the coax cable. Thank you and have a good day.